I'm Peter Brown from Tiny and Sons Glass. Tiny and Sons Glass was established in 1978 with my father and brother and I. We're at 575 Washington Street in Pembroke. We're certified and qualified to do all your windshield replacement and repair. Tiny and Sons Glass is a community-based business. We have 12 mobile vans that come to you. If the weather's bad, you can come here to the shop. We have a nice waiting area, TV, Wi-Fi, kid-friendly, pet-friendly. We also can move about 15, 20 cars a day through the shop. Perfect for you when the weather's bad. So come on down to Tiny and Sons Glass if you need your windshield replaced or repaired. Tiny and Sons Glass, 1-888-64-TINIES. Just call. Thank you.
I'm Arthur Boyle of Performance Appraisal Services. We're residential real estate appraisers with a company founded in 1994 by Mike Gianelli and I in the basement of my house in Malden. We've since grown to have offices in Malden and Pembroke. We serve the eastern Mass counties, including Cape Cod. A good client for us is an attorney or a private landowner or a private property owner who's going through a probate process or a divorce division of property. Call us at 781-293-6900. Ask for Arthur Boyle or Amanda Boyle Grazioso. Our first name is Performance.
It is now 7:30, and I'll just state that the meeting is open. 7:32 p.m., February 6, 2017. Members present this evening are, Administrative Assistant Mary Guiney, Rick Madden, Egerton, Sharon Tuell, myself, Andy Stevenson, Scott Glauben, and Adrian Bob Clarke is in a meeting, but he'll be right with us. Our first appointment of this evening, scheduled for 7:30, is for Mr. Dave Mellon, who is volunteering for an open space on the open space committee.
That's me.
How are you?
Good, thanks. I'll move up one anyways.
Yeah, sure. Come on up. Front row. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Excellent. Looks pretty good. What makes you interested in the open space committee?
Oh, I've always been interested in, you know, the natural resource of conservation. In fact, back in the 80s, I was very interested in the Conservation Commission. I attended a lot of meetings, but back then, it used to be Saturday mornings with site visits, and Saturday mornings was work for me. And in fact, it was overtime for me, and so I was working. I didn't have the time. But I have been a member of the Historic District Commission and the Historic Commission for 35 years. I just retired. Well, I retired a few years ago, so now I have time. I was a civil engineer. I worked for Public Works in the city of Boston for almost 40 years.
Yeah.
So I get public service. For a couple of years I've been in the Army. I've spent my entire adult life in public service. So I get that whole bit. And I'm interested and believe in it. I had heard about the guys and students from Conway School working on a plan for the town, and there was a meeting going on just last week, really.
Yeah.
At the library, and I went down, looked at it. You know, looks like a lot of work. I don't know if they're prepared for it, I'd get involved.
Great.
Always willing to have help.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah. The Historic Commission, the Historic District Commission was a separate commission back in like 1985. And we just got to a point we could not get a quorum, so we actually combined with now the Historic/Historic District Commission.
Oh, no kidding.
And so that we can have at least four members or something at a meeting for a quorum. So it's hard to get people.
Sometimes you get the better people that way.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Any motion to hire Dave Mellon for the Open Space Committee vacancy?
Okay. Motion's been made to approve.
Second.
And seconded. Any discussion or further questions for
Dave? No.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
I actually do have one question.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so is the Open Space Committee A separate committee? Yeah, is it a subcommittee of the Conservation Commission? No, I understand that.
So when you get in trouble, you get sent to our office.
That's all.
When we get in trouble, you get sent out with you tomorrow.
You met Mike McDonald last week?
I did, yes, yeah.
He's the chairperson. Denise Moraski was there and Linda McCullum.
So would you forward my contact information to them?
Yeah.
And I did have an application.
Good, thank you very much.
Excellent.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Excuse me.
Thank you, sir.
Mary, does he have to get sworn in by Mary Ann?
Oh, you may have to get sworn in by Mary Ann.
Okay, yeah, I can.
Yeah, I think you might have to get sworn in by the town clerk.
Okay, maybe I can book it now. Well, I'll come in tomorrow.
Yeah.
Don't come in until next week, she's out.
Oh, okay, well, they won't come in then. All right, I'll be in next week.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Oops, I take my hat.
We have a few minutes.
Did you start reviewing these minutes?
Yes, yeah. I have got here early and read them all, so we should be looking at that. Has anybody not read?
I'm not quite done, but I can start.
Okay, so we can give that a few minutes and I'll watch you do so, sir.
I mean, you can start. I've read a lot of these. Don't have any issues.
Well, the first one is to vote to release the executive session minutes.
From previous weekend, okay.
That we reviewed and approved.
Okay. Yeah, there's plenty. I looked at there's a few other things on here. We can kind of just go on.
The MACC conference, how's that?
MACC conference, we can start right with that. Todd, I saw you had a few things, right? That's that one there?
I have three classes signed up for it. I'm playing with the R right now.
Yeah, that's okay.
He's only registered.
Yeah, and then whatever Clark is doing on those, I'm going to tag on.
Excellent.
Bunch of information, pamphlets, all sorts of great stuff.
And then we never have time to show up to the committee.
I'd like to be on the edge of the trail. Oh, that's the mail. There's a mail call that everybody has.
Okay, yeah. Well, we'll leave for this briefing.
Okay.
Oh,
thank you. We'll take a few minutes to go right through this. We have also for open business is we have Wild Parchment. Nothing new to report on that. Big pile at the pit. We're good with that.
Well, that's the in the Route 14
corridor.
Outside of that, we still have to comprehensive plan this spring. We talked to a man that has a company up in the cross center possible at old lumberyard.
He came in last fall
and talked to us, left his information. I want to get back in touch with him about digging out.
Well, the landscape,
yeah.
Yeah, I thought he was going to put something together for us.
I wanted to get back in touch with us and say, get him back in and figure out what we're going to do, what we can do, what we can't do. And get on it before it's another year.
Yep.
It goes fast.
Yeah, it does.
You know. No, it's good. They dug out. That's all. Factory, that's good. We have to be a little residual here, snip here or there. You know. What do we do on that one? If it's on private property, out of that easement, real quick. Route 14 car, the new property we bought.
Mm-hmm. That's ours.
In that corner. So that whole blueberry patch up the road goes with that property?
I believe that our property goes all the way to that next driveway.
Okay, because there's what, like just off the highway on that side of the road, there's a very few line to get them to get going.
Yeah, I think our property, I can't remember the gentleman's name, but it looks like the Munsters way out in the woods out there.
What I want to do is at least in areas where it's not really bad, get it out of there to stop it from spreading in further directions.
As far as we had landers do, we worked within the scope of the layout.
Right.
But I know it's a little further. A little further behind that.
Yeah. When you get over that blueberry patch on that side of the road, because don't even have 5 or 6 in there.
Mm.
That's easy. Other side of the road, though, Harrington side is
loaded.
Further consideration. Table for further consideration.
Yeah, well, after we find out what the gentleman's got to say.
What the state has to say, whatever he has to say, probably get in there and dig them out. I just thought it'd be cut it first. It froze. Cut it. It'd be a lot easier to deal with.
Yeah. The only thing, I know, having somebody spray it, talking to the gentleman I dealt with, you have to have a right-of-way license in this state to be able to spray. That's any side of the street there. Just another way for the state to get another dollar out of you.
I'm sure.
But, if we get something.
If it freezes, I just think it's great to mow it right down to nothing. And then we wouldn't have to dig out or anything else. It's a lot easier than playing with pucker brush.
Well, it's definitely messing now. I'm good.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I am too.
They have static on them. They cling to us and drop off
anywhere. Put a post-it note here, pick me up, here, pick me up.
Ziggy, you missed.
Ooh. That's the smiley face. Hi, Ziggy. Bug wouldn't complain until after 4 o'clock.
No, what he really complains about when you're walking with muddy feet right after you wash the floor. Oh, sorry.
He washes that floor every day. You come in here, or you leave at night, and it's white footprint all over the place, and it's washed the next morning. But you
know. We can go on to Madden Small Fields, where we are on the show. Yes, I believe so. Anything new on the Madden Ball Fields? Is still working on a tree plan? Or? Anything new on the Madden at Ball Fields? We're still working on the tree plan for that or a proposal?
Trying to work with Greg and get a good proposal together and solid.
The tree work.
Anybody's interested in knowing about Atlantic species trees?
It's all right.
Just the benefits of it. How important is the species?
There was another meeting, was that 2 weeks ago? Was that when you talked about?
Yeah, was it 2 weeks ago?
Yeah. All right, so that's the same.
Yeah, it was after our last one, yeah.
Those kids are really on top of things. They seem like they definitely know what they're doing.
Awesome. Yeah, they're going to get in there and get it done.
Yeah.
And I love the long-termness that their fact-finding mission before they even started.
They really did the job. They really had the densities down. They had the trends. They had development. What we're planning the next. It's a good long-term plan, not just the long.
Right.
And they did almost for the bicentennial, wasn't it?
2020. They did the last open space plan was 2005.
Yeah, okay. 2005. And that's what we need is 10, 15 year look down the road in development trends and resources in there. I'll be interested to see their final plan with the input that everybody gave.
They have a survey online that's available to all of you. I sent an email. So if you're ready to take that. Deb Wall has put it on the website, and they're announcing it next door tonight.
Okay.
Television cameras, and there's also a second community meeting scheduled for March 2nd. And I believe that these three kids, as you know, all the kids, they're graduate students, will be making a presentation to the faculty at the Conway School on February 24th at 2 o'clock. So I don't know if anybody wants to drive out.
I'm sorry, February what?
February 24th at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Mike McDonough is going out. And I can send it. When he gets that information, I can send it out. Anyone tries to?
Yeah. I don't know if I can answer that date, but I'm not here.
And then you can just send it to my which will have to happen with the university.
Okay. That takes care of that. One of the discussions now. Actually, is everybody ready in a minute? Okay,
that's good.
So we have for administrative business, we vote to release the executive session minutes from May 16th, 2016 and January 23rd, 2017. Everybody's had time to read and review those?
Yep. Any of these minutes, the ones that the select persons possibly signing a executive session for, please? We're good.
Those are not right. Okay, so I need a motion to approve.
A motion to approve.
Release.
Release.
I second.
Okay, motion's been made and seconded. If there's no further questions to these, then all in favor of releasing those two executive session minutes from the one from May 16, 2016 and one from January 23, 2017. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Do we have to do that by roll call, Mary, to release these? I know we did a roll call when we did
the end of the meeting. Hold on, let's do a roll call.
Okay. I don't know.
Better city.
All right.
So now we'll have a roll call vote to release the executive session minutes. Can we do them both at once, or do we have to do them individually?
Both at once.
Yeah, both at once.
Yeah. You sure?
Sure. Okay. It's your name on the bottom line.
May 16, 2016 and January 23rd, 2017. Scott Glauben?
Yes.
Sharon Tuell?
Yes.
Todd Edgerton?
Yes.
Rick Madden?
Yes.
Me, yes. And I think that's it, right?
Yes.
All right.
Scott
Glauben.
Oh.
Greg's not here, and
Bob is just a.
Okay, Bob is just
I'm out there, Bob. Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, okay, in BC. Yes.
And Mr. Clarke, do you approve releasing the executive session minutes for May 16th and May 16th,
yes.
2016 and January 23rd, 2017?
Yes.
Excellent. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. We also have minutes for around for March 7th, 2016 January 9th, 2017, and January 23rd, 2017 to approve. Has everybody reviewed those? Is there any questions or differences?
You said 16.
There was a date on
March 7th, 2016, January 9th, 2017, January 23rd, 2017.
Yeah,
you got it, you fixed it already?
Okay. I haven't fixed it, but I do it.
Alright. So we're good.
Okay.
Okay.
Second.
Was motion made?
Motion to accept the minutes of the meeting.
Okay, motion's been made.
Second.
And seconded. Any other issues with those minutes? Okay. All in favor of accepting the meeting minutes from March 7th, 2016, January 9th, 2017, and January 23rd, 2017? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Do we have to do a roll call on that?
No, there's an aye.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and we can now, I believe, start our 7:40 here. So, Rachel, is it Michael?
Yes.
Okay, Rachel Michael is a candidate for our administrative agent. Come on.
How would you like me to?
How are you? Thank you.
Andy, if I could, I just want to say Rachel has been in our office for a few hours, understands where we're working from and all that. We have been asked her if she would be a tie between the time we can officially hire someone and when Mary leaves, and she has agreed that she'll come in and help us over that part of it anyway. But she also was here to be interviewed for the job. I think she has a very impressive resume. I really don't know why she's here. I mean, she's well above. Though we've always had good administrators taking care of us.
Who are you ready to say B for?
Daniel Webster.
Is there anything you want to ask us first about this? Though you probably have, Rachel is, I don't know your official title, but she's executive assistant for the CPC. Is that close enough?
Yes, that's close.
So she is familiar with the town, with Pembroke. She does, as you see, live in Pembroke, has a family here, and all that. But maybe she doesn't know all of us. Do you?
I don't.
She don't. All right, then maybe we ought to start right at the very part. Introduce ourselves.
I'm Mary. We have met.
Yes.
I have been working with Rachel for the last 3.5 years as CPC because our office does get a lot of calls. And I'm going to say that every communication I've had with Rachel has been very professional and pleasant. I've also done my own little cognizance around town, and it's been very positive.
So. Rick Madden, just conservation commissioner, I'm tied with the green guy.
Okay.
And plant guy.
Okay.
I'm already Egerton. I've always had interest in environment and making sure that it's not violated. And so that's why I'm here. I also have Pembroke Town News. If you see me running the camera,
I do.
Doing that too.
Yes.
Sharon Tuells, grew up here, was away for a while, came back, and things have changed a lot. But, I got into this, and I'm interested in the heron run, and I want to see the upgrades and improvement in that. So that's one of my main things that I'm interested in.
Excellent. Andy Stevenson, been in town 12, 13 years now, decided to volunteer time. These guys somehow nominated me to chair it. I'm quite sure why that is. But like a few of us here, we're all very new. You know, trying to learn as quick as possible, and more importantly, do the right thing. You know, it takes a lot of guidance on my end. I rely heavily on what's that, you know. Other than that, you know, it just, we look forward to it and just try to keep everything the right way.
Scott Glauben, we've dealt
a
few times in the past.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome aboard.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Are you sure?
Okay. She knows who I am. And
everybody knows.
He's the guy with a big bag of life savings.
I don't know where they came from. I was gone when they arrived. Here.
Okay. I can't think of anything else to be there, you know, to volunteer to come over and help us out. It's
amazing. Did you?
Very appreciate it.
Somewhere here there was was it sent off to the qualification?
I
don't have
one, but I don't know.
To give to me? Because I viewed it.
I want to ask about it. It said that we have these twice a month. Maybe we should fix it so that it's the same as one. We
get on board first.
Don't scare
them. I want to stand up that we did not write that. That came out of
upstairs. You know, they listed hours that were, I told Rachel they were flexible, that or whoever that you do hire would be making their own hours depending on their schedule. Consistent hours.
Yes.
That we would.
Again, so the board knows this, the job officially is 21-hour job, which makes it
20.
I thought we had 21 to make it over the lake. Oh.
I haven't been paid
20. Yes, it's the way it's set up. I thought it was a 21. That makes it a job that has
benefits. It does come with benefits.
Deer in the headlights.
And we also add if we have a workload greater than what the 21 hours allows us to do, we compensate at the same rate for whatever over that. And I don't have a fine figure. I know that they quoted a figure as what the beginning rate was here, and there's steps up and all of that.
But if we find somebody qualified and we feel we need to offer them more money, I believe we have that right to do that also.
Through wage and personnel.
Did they do it on the office next to ours when they did that?
You know, I don't know, but when I was hired,
we had to go to wage and personnel.
I had to go to wage and personnel.
Because Mary had been doing the same thing, so she had years of some time there. Yeah. Sometimes we have to do things, even though we may not think we have to. It's easier to do them than. Other than that, I'm very happy that she has applied. When Mary first told me she was looking and pretty sure she was leaving, I had almost a heart attack trying to figure out what was going to happen. As you probably heard us joke, I told her she could leave as long as she stayed for 4 years.
Right. 4 year notice.
4 year notice.
And then we started looking, and it didn't take me very long. Talked to Rachel one day, asked her if she was still interested in this in coming here. Rachel had applied for this job 3.5 years ago. And it was very close. Mary, we hired Mary, but she was right on Mary's.
I wrote a letter to the banker, and this the merchant called me up.
almost like persistent pages.
How far? Say we have to go through our process. I think Mary's at 24th. Is that the day you said that?
The 24th. So on the 27th, I assume you make a decision.
Have we had any other applicants?
No, that we know of. This is the only applicant that our office
has. We still have to wait till the 24th.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we table it till the 24th?
So we can act on it?
Well, we can, actually, this is where we're seeing her now. We don't have to do it. Maybe we should say that we're something to the effect that we're going to utilize her in the meantime to carry over from Mary until such time as we can officially hire someone.
Whatever Bob just said.
Yeah.
So we need a motion to hire Rachel as an interim temporary administrative agent until the 27th.
Make a motion that we hire for, she just said, until the 27th.
I second that.
Okay. So motion has been made and seconded. Is there any further questions or discussions?
I said it better.
No? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Congratulations, whether you think of it or not.
Thank you.
And for the record, I would also like to thank Mary for her time and
yes.
patience.
Yes.
Especially
thank you.
With yes. yours truly, I can only speak for myself. I really appreciate it, as I had stated before.
The guidance, she really works well in helping people.
She plays well with others.
Yes.
Whereas knowledge. I typically don't.
And her knowledge about what she does is like Bob's. It is soul deep. It's almost irreplaceable. You got a hard bench to fill here.
Yes,
you know,
absolutely.
Oh, growth.
Thank you. Thank you. We appreciate it. I look forward to it. Should it become permanent?
On the 27th.
Yes.
She can submit her voucher for to attend the MACC conference.
When do they have to begin by?
She'd show up the day of, but...
No, yeah. When is the regular...
Yeah, the 27th. She can come in that Tuesday and submit the voucher to see.
Like, I don't know that I have the letter.
Well, we're looking at it, can we have it all ready to go?
It
might even sneak into the mail ahead of time.
That could happen.
Good thing
you're not on camera.
I guess.
Oh, you are? Oh, excuse me.
You can always change the name if you're going to meet somebody else.
He's just referring to the post date of 11:59 p.m. the night before, that's all.
Yeah. You just put it in Tuesday, she'll show up, and they have two lines at the conference for people who have paid and people who haven't. Because many towns takes a long time to process the people.
And I don't know if that.
Yep.
So that way you were getting him on. That I should register in advance but just not submit a payment? How did this happen?
But what I'm saying is, if for some reason she wasn't appointed and someone else was, they would probably want to go. So we have something in there that would cover us and
we have a placeholder.
And it's just so much easier to be paid ahead than it is to stand in those lines and try to sort through things at a place like that.
You're not even important. Watch the fast.
Okay, and the classes that we selected for Rachel were how to run an efficient office, that sort of stuff.
How to run a meeting.
How to run a meeting.
All the wetlands, so all the water on the table gets the
all
position.
The okay.
All the good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank
you
very
much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Rachel, will you still be doing the CPC stuff too?
Yes.
I will. But as you know, it's very part-time, so it should not interfere with this at all.
Oh, no, I like to have somebody I can go talk to.
Well, that too. And I mean, I think this is going to be a nice bridge.
Good.
A nice connection, you know, between the CPC and you guys, so... I'm excited.
Excellent.
I hope it all works out. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Have a good night.
You too. Thank you.
Okay.
Board discussions. We were on the, we take care of the MACC. We have the Indian Head River Trail Grant application that I saw a nice letter from the town of Hanson this evening, that they're aboard and joining.
Yes, there's also very nice letters in the application that we received from North South River.
Yep.
We received one from Wildlands Trust and from the town of Hanover.
Excellent.
And from the town of Hanover's Open Space Committee.
Nice.
Great.
So,
Was there a letter in there from Doc Roberts?
And a letter from Doc Roberts, thank you. Bob went and approached the landowner that's on the west side.
Yep.
So when he signed off and he gave us a copy of the plan.
Nice.
That I took to Staples and had copied. So we have a copy, Bob has a copy,
yeah,
and he returned the original.
Nice, excellent.
So hopefully that'll...
The only thing we have up in the air that we're working on is the Edison Company out at the parking lot area. Where the parking is right now, a good part of that is on Edison's property, where the transformer used to be. So we're trying to find out who over there you really talk to. You know, either get them to sign off on the property or at least give us a release so we know.
Allow access.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I remember that bang. It's about a mile down the road from us.
I remember when all the fluid leaked out of it.
Yeah, but boom.
So you've brought up another possible
problem. I was just going to say,
problem
is up?
I would have hoped that they took care of that
they
at
did.
The time. They did.
They did. That was all, that
yeah.
whole road was dug up.
Yeah.
All the way,
yeah.
and
yeah.
because if even if we do get them to give it to us, we may have to do
a test,
61 or whatever that they call it, just a soil before accepting it.
21E.
What? 21E, yeah.
21E is, yeah,
yeah.
Soil board.
Yeah, we may have to do a 21E just to be able to accept the piece of property where it was transformed.
Yeah, they actually got it before it got to the river.
I can do that.
Good.
Okay, we're gonna hire
you again.
In your 4 years you left here, well, let's send you up there to do your 21.
4 year notice, that was good. Oh. All right, so we're good with that. Solutions for Healthy Waters 2017 conference is also in the, that's at March 16, 2017, 8 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. at Camp Kalani in Hanson.
Mary, do you know what this is really?
This is this is something that Art is attending.
Oh, I'm going to work to do some video with him. That makes sense.
Do we have to sign up for that one, Mary?
Yes, and I tried signing up online today for Rick, and we need a credit card.
Even for the one in Hanson?
This is the one in Hanson I was talking about. So I sent an email to there and asking how we register, and that I need a voucher for commission on this. So if anybody's interested, should I put it on the agenda for the next meeting?
Yes, please. I just
got
to check in, see what if there's anything else going on with that date. Because there's also stormwater stuff in there. So.
Yeah.
It's pretty comprehensive.
And we had a request for a certificate of compliance for 19 Canoe Club Lane, DEP file number SC56-927.
Is it right here, Mary? Somewhere?
Yes, I have two of them in there, one for partial and one for complete.
I've looked at it and I believe that we might as well give them their complete one. It's compared to all the other houses on Canoe Club Lane, it's not up to the standards of the other houses there, but it's up to a standard that we have anywhere else in town, and rather than just keep going with paperwork.
Is that the first one on the right?
Yeah. Yeah.
He hasn't even got the lawn established.
Well, he's got growth in the lawn. It's weed, but it's growth. You know, it's what do you...
Hey, no herbicides, you know, right on the lawn.
I don't think he's brought any loom in even. You look at it, it's pretty bony up there.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I say, it's not pretty.
He should just throw salty grass on it and grow a beautiful one, just like that.
But what I was basing on, I've gone by there through the winter and it's not coming down into the catch basin.
No.
So there's that's established, and there's
yeah.
something the other way is it may not be lawn, but whatever is there has established that we aren't getting a, no,
no runoff.
A runoff. So,
no salted runoff.
Hopefully the people that will buy the place will take more pride in it than the builder has.
Well, I heard he's living there.
It's for sale.
Is it?
Yeah, there's a for sale sign.
Yeah, he was living there because we chased him down forever.
Okay. So we have a motion to grant?
Yeah, I'm going to reissue us here for the compliance.
Okay. And prior to that.
Why does he have to come in to talk to us? He doesn't need to come in to talk to us?
They don't force us to be in compliance.
Okay.
We had looked at this last fall or last year.
Yeah, and there was things that we needed him to do.
We sent it to my office.
Okay.
Yep. The motion's been made to grant certificate of compliance for 19 canoe foot length.
Yep.
And seconded. Any further discussion? Okay. All in favor to grant the certificate of compliance for 19 canoe foot length, EDT file number SC56-927?
Aye.
Aye.
I voted.
Scott abstains. Buff?
Yeah.
And Buff is so we have four yeses and one abstain. Scott abstains.
Oh, Scott abstains?
Scott abstains.
Okay.
So five yeses.
Not four.
Four.
Scott abstain.
Buff.
Okay. Okay, abstain not. Okay.
Just not voting on it.
Not voting, okay.
Was DEP, was DPW satisfied with the catch basins or not?
We were never able to get a hold of the gentleman to talk to him.
And the last one is 70 old car path.
All right, old car path was the last meeting we had with a ANRAD and considerable discussion about perennial and intermittent stream.
Yes.
The engineers had called it intermittent stream, and their narrative said that a 2015 USGA map showed it as intermittent. Since that time, Mary and myself a little bit have been pushing the proponent and the engineers to produce for us a plan that showed it as a intermittent stream. And today, finally, they came up with something, and they say, well, you look at the plan and the stream is a little lighter colored blue up in this area than it is someplace else, and the lighter the blue, the more it is intermittent. Well,
I thought it had to stop.
Mary looked at it pretty tightly. I looked at it pretty tightly. I surely don't see any big difference, if any difference, on the color of the line that shows the stream from one place to the other. And if that's the case, then it would be a perennial and not an intermittent, as the engineering people said. So Mary has tweaked up what we voted on last week, and I think we need to re-vote it to the point where we're saying, yes, we agree with your lines, we agree with all of this. We can't agree with your stream because you can't produce to us the information to back up what you say is there.
And when we had done that, we had really agreed upon it, like kind of in distress and like had to agree, because you had not enough information for it, so.
Well, so they just could not, to my satisfaction, anyway, they have not been able to come up with anything to back up what they said.
Correct.
And so if there's something wrong with what they said, then we have a right to, to change our, what we have done. We were basing it on an engineer's statement.
The wetland scientist said that he says that the dark blue, light blue, he did not pull the actual quad map for the site, meaning he did not look at a USGS map. We have a USGS map online in the room that, on the computer that I rely on. The abutters that were here last week, I've been in and we went through the historical USGS maps that go back, that go back 150 years or so. And they all shows a perennial stream.
So the map has been right all along, but somebody said it was...
It was like a misread of data on the part of whoever did it.
It was a misread in their favor.
Okay.
Yeah. Right.
My personal opinion is if Kevin Gray comes in here and says something, you can usually take it to the bank.
It's one of those things, too, though, when you rely on the color on a reproduction print, I mean, to tell you what something is, you... are getting very close to.
So what is our course of action on this?
We have a new one, Mary.
Okay, here we got our special conditions. What is that?
Okay, under the, we were saying accurate, the boundaries described on the reference plan and the abbreviated notice of resource area delineation are accurately drawn for the following resource areas. Bordered vegetated wetlands, yes. Other resource areas, we specify. The top of the bank and east side of the perennial stream, we determined to be accurate. Modified. But basically, it says the intermittent stream, as shown on the plan, has determined to be perennial based on a review of the USGS maps and field observations at the site. The inaccurate, the intermittent stream as shown on the plan has determined to be a perennial based on a review of the USGS maps and field observations of the site.
Works for me?
Yeah.
I so move that we change our decision on that to read as I just read.
Second. Based on the information provided and the change in information we were provided, the recommendation is to change jobs with the wording that was just read. Any further questions on that? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
What this also does now, though, it takes the responsibility and the cost of challenging it off of the neighbors and puts it back on to the person who brought it in.
Which was not comfortable being the answer at that point because I didn't want to say yes or no to that. And he said the USGS would want to hand a dispute to the USGS map. What we were given at that time, we don't have the resources to have a laptop here.
If you walk that
show it right here.
If you walk that brook up to its head, you find springs. Then it was fine.
Right.
Everyone I've talked to up and down that stream say that it runs.
All the time.
Yeah.
Okay. So on to administrative business. We have the Zoning Board of Appeals decision for 49 Furnace Lane. We'll do it here. Anybody read that? The letter of support to Hanson, I covered that. The planning board notice hearing the definitive subdivision for 73 Taylor Street. Email correspondence regarding the 2015 USGS map for Path Lane that we just read. Voucher for MACC Environmental Conference that we signed for our Egerton. Agent payroll was in that. Mary checked for hours. Order of resource delineation that we just discussed. Copies of statements in the Kate Husby.
Okay, but we'll change that partial COC to a full.
Yes, we covered that up. And that's a wrap, folks. Motion to close the meeting, seconded, all in favor?
Yeah, let me close, I'd like to really thank Mary for that.
Thank you very much. That's what I...
Thank you, I have enjoyed working with all of you.
Even you?
Yeah.
I hope your new job works out very well for you.
Thank you, I hope so.
And you're welcome to come back anytime you want.
Anytime you're feeling bored, there's always something here to do.
No kidding, yeah.
But we can't use you as a consultant for...
Oh, I think they call it mutual aid.
Mutual aid, you come from mutual aid, but as a consultant, you have to wait so much, 6 months or something.
No, I don't think I can ever come back.
No?
No. I think the look that people is forever.
And it's forever?
I'm not sure about that.
I know it was a long time.
Yeah, it was like 2-3 years. Then I could go work for a consultant.
But we're off. I'm going to also say to